I started off playing eight ball, and then my dad took me down to the local snooker club, and I was only about 9 at the time, and I started playing nine. I started going once a week, and then Willie Thorne's brother Malcolm spotted me, and he said to me that I should start going in the junior tournaments and stuff. So I went in the first junior tournament, and I'd done quite well, and he watched me play, and he said that I could start getting free practice down there, and in the end he ended up sponsoring me for a couple of years. I've had a reasonable season. Last year I struggled, so I mean this year I was under a lot of pressure, and I've come through really well. I beat players like O'Sullivan and Endre, so there's no reason why I can't beat players like John Higgins. I've got the self-belief to beat them, just on the table and on the day. John's a great player. I mean, I've never played him before, but I mean, he's set a lot of records, and like, I watched him on the telly a lot when I was like junior coming up, and I mean, it's just a really good experience to be playing a big name at Sheffield for the first time. I'd like to be in the top 8 in the world, if not number 1. I mean, that's my aim, to get number 1, but I mean, I think in 5 years' time I'll be in the 16, but I would like to be in the top 8.
Yes, good shot. Well, now we take a little look back to the Mark Selby match earlier today against Ding Junhui. And this was an eagerly anticipated match, with Ding, of course, coming straight from Wembley, where he atoned for 2007 by winning the Masters title. But he found Mark Selby just too much to handle, as indeed Stephen Hendry had the day before. And here you see Mark just wrapping things up.
Harder. And ball.
Been a few shocks and surprises in the week so far, but not here today. And he's finishing in some style. Well, what a way to finish.
Oh, playing one with the back end of the queue. A little bit soothing there, but never mind.